Hey everyone, it's Brie. I'm back with another scrapbook process video for the Hip Kit Club design team. And today is Mixed Media Monday, and I am working with the August 2021 Hip Kits. I am using the Play Hard Always cut file. It is from the August/September release. I don't think they've been uploaded to the website. I'm not really sure. If they haven't, they will be uploaded soon. I know they were having some technical issues, so just be patient and they will be uploaded as soon as they possibly can. But I'm working with the August color kit here, and these three ink pads are from Catherine Pooler. I'm working with Limoncello, Be Mine, and Something Borrowed. And all I'm doing is I'm ink blending on to the inner pieces of the cut file. When I was in my Silhouette design studio, I went ahead and took those inner pieces and offset them so that they'd be ready to back the cut file with as soon as I was done ink blending. And all I'm doing is I'm taking my blending brush and rubbing it into the ink, pouncing it on my glass mat, and then kind of from the outside working in, trying to bring in the ink. Now in a few spots you could see that there are some really bold brush marks, because these these ink pads are super juicy, and so I wasn't prepared. So definitely pounce them. I mean, it's fantastic how juicy they are. There's so much ink and they're so beautiful and vibrant. Just be careful, and I tend to be a little heavy-handed when I create, so just a tip, just work from the outside in, and then you can avoid having some, you know, thick spots if you get them. You know, maybe even blend off the paper, and then bring the color in and just be light. And all I'm doing is just going back through, adding more pink, adding more yellow, and trying to blend them as much as I can or could. And I wasn't really concerned that I had a few bold spots because I was going to back the cut file, and you really couldn't tell, and it was fine with me. And I do end up splattering some white paint as well, so it just kind of brings everything together. Now, I did take the cut file off of my mat, and I'm going to go ahead and ink blend the always portion of the cut file using Limoncello. I just wanted to bring a little bit of color to that word and have it pop. Now, a tip, I did leave everything on my cutting mat because I was ink blending and I didn't want everything to move around. So that's why I left everything on my cutting mat, so everything stayed put, and it made the whole process a lot smoother. So now I'm going to work on the background. Now, since I did so much ink blending on the inner pieces of my cut file, I just wanted a little bit of something. I did think about ink blending the ink again, but then I thought, oh, let's just, you know, make a nice watercolory look. So I'm just doing the packaging technique with the Something Borrowed color, and I just put it on my piece of packaging, and I added some clean water, and then I'm just going in and smushing the packaging onto my background paper, and I didn't use gesso. I'm just lightly placing it on. I didn't add too much liquid, so I didn't add any gesso, and I did want some of the texture from that cardstock to show through. So I put that aside to dry, and then I'm going to go ahead and do some ink splatters onto my letters, and you can see how well the ink turned out. And then I did fail to mention that, you know, when I was talking about the really bold marks from my brush, if you give it a chance to dry, the ink will smooth itself out from the ink pad. So, you know, just give it a chance to dry for all the colors to blend, and it blended and dried beautifully. Like, you honestly, I don't even see the big bold marks anymore. So just give your paper a chance to dry and for it to be absorbed into whatever cardstock you're using. So I popped everything up on foam tape and applied my cut file down. I was going back and forth as to where my photo was going to be, but in the end I chose it to go like nestle in between the Y and the D. And I am matting my photo with some Pocket Life cards from the Pocket Life kit, and then I'm going to staple them together just like, you know, as if it was laying on my desk. And I roughed up the edges, so it was just like a very messy mat, and I love how it turned out. So as you can see, this cut file is super bold with the backed cut file and the ink blending. I don't know if you've given ink blending a try. I'm completely addicted to it right now. I think it's so fun. And I've mentioned this before in a few of my other videos that it's very therapeutic, and it's just, you know, you get the ink and then you're blending it, and it's just, I don't know, to me it's magic, and I love how it turns out. Now, just a heads up, if you do white splatters onto your inked pieces, just be prepared that some of that color will be absorbed into your white ink, or not white ink, your white paint. And I didn't mind. I just wanted it to look messy and fun, because this photo is of my son playing his first football game for eighth grade football. And so I did want it to look messy and, you know, just have that look. And I didn't mind at all. So yeah, no worries. But just a heads up, in case you weren't aware, and you do add white paint splatters, the ink that you are applying it to could come up into that white paint. All right, so I am just creating some clusters using all of the August 2021 kits. I've got some floral foam thickers from Amy Tangerine. I've got a few of the exclusive ephemera pieces. One says No Guts, No Glory. One says So Much Fun. I did add a few of the Amy Tangerine stickers. And then lastly, I'm just going to finish it off with a few stars from this Vicky Booten color story. Is it color story or color study? Maybe it's color study. I think it's color study. From the 6x12 cardstock sticker sheet. And that about does it. I did add some tangle thread. I don't think I added that. And I also added some gold little sticker dots. But for the most part, the focus other than the photo was this cut file backed with some ink blending. And I had so much fun. Stay tuned for my final layout as well as some up close shots. I had so much fun with this layout. I hope I've inspired you in some way today. Thank you so much for watching, commenting, and subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate it. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.